Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the beautiful Sultanate of Oman for the ISAF Rolex World Sailor of the Year Awards for 2013.
It would be amiss of me not to mention the setup at the St. Francis and how powerful that has been in the success of course kiteboarding, but also in your and Johnny's success.
Yeah, I mean, the St. Francis Yacht Club has supported board sports since the beginning, and with kiting, we pretty much developed the sport there, and it's continuing to progress, and Johnny and I would not be here without the support of the Yacht Club and the foundation.
What really grasped you about the sport, and particularly that style of intense racing?
In the beginning, I was struck by the beautiful silence of sailing. And from that time, I started to develop this passion for adrenaline. 35 knots of breeze, it's quite scary. It's always on the edge, and I found myself rather addicted to that.
Joe and Polly, fresh out the Olympic Games, gold medal there. What is it that even after such amazing success in London has brought you back straight into it again?
So we sat down together and had a goal to get to Rio, hopefully in 2016. So that's sort of driving us at the moment.
We've always wanted to do better. There's still things we can do better. So there's always something to do. And until we tick that off, I guess we'll keep going.
I first met Rhea 2 years ago. She'd never, ever been sailing before. And Rhea, here you are now.
I never thought that I can reach this level. And when I started sailing, it was like this is a completely something new for me. I never have a background about it. And every time I take a new steps, I think about it, and then I think this is awesome.
Right now it's time to find out who you, the ISAF member nations, have voted as the ISAF Rolex World Sailors of the Year for 2013.
The female winner of the 2013 Rolex World Sailor of the Year is Jo Allen and Polly Barry.
A little bit shocked to be up here.
Yeah.
Some amazing nominees this year. We were just, I think, really excited to be part of this.
Like all the nominees, we haven't done this alone, and we've had some wonderful people behind us, so thank you.
Ian Williams, 4 times world champion, equaled Gilmore's record this year. I mean, that is significant. That must have been quite special.
Oh, absolutely. The names mentioned there, Russell, Chris and Ed and of course Peter, they're really my heroes growing up in sailing, so to be mentioned in the same terms is incredible for me.
Johnny, talk to me about your 3 world championship results. Why have you been so dominant in this?
You know, it's funny, I'm sitting here and I hear that, you know, that the team answer is the standard thing for this, and it's kind of true for an individual sport like kiting as well, where in the Bay Area we have a really strong local fleet, and I'm fortunate to have a ton of good training partners that push me all the time. So I think that's as important as any background you can have, is have guys that are good to sail with.
I knew it was a fast time, but it was such a big step from 59 to 65 knots. For me, I was thinking the whole world is going to try and digest that massive jump that we've just made in sailing in general, really. We've given a new hurdle for people to jump over, and it was overwhelming. I watch it now and I'm still overwhelmed by it. It's an amazing moment.
When you look at the diversity of our sport, and listening and watching the videos of what, you know, what these gentlemen next to me have achieved, how do you compare? And you know, I just love competing. I'm very competitive, and I love the Olympic side and what the Olympics represent. And I'm just fortunate that, you know, I'm here nominated alongside these guys and enjoy doing what I do.
The male winner of 2013 ISAF Rolex World Sailor of the Year, Matthew Belcher.
I normally have someone else, you know, up here. As you know, I sail a 470, and you know, it's a team boat. And the 470 has been an amazing class for myself and the people and the partners that I've had. And here tonight, Malcolm, you know, we've had an amazing journey, winning 3 world championships and an Olympic gold. He's been a massive part of it. And my new sailing partner, Will Ryan, who unfortunately couldn't be here tonight. Yeah, it's exciting times for myself, and this year has been very difficult in a lot of ways, but it's been hugely rewarding.
Oh, we're pretty incredible to win this ISAF World, Rolex World Sailor of the Year. I think I definitely wasn't expecting it. The nominees were incredible this year. Just to be part of that group was an honour. So, yeah, pretty amazed, really.
It's a huge honour to win the ISAF Rolex World Sailor of the Year this year. You know, what a privilege to be recognised at this level and you know, to come away with the top prize.